Hello, welcome to In 5 Minutes. Today we will be starting with inverse Laplace transform. Now, let's discuss introduction to inverse Laplace transform. We know it very well. Laplace of f of t is given by 0 to infinity e raised to minus st f of t dt, which is nothing but equal to phi of s. So we know when a function f of t is transformed to phi of s, that means we do Laplace transform. Now, when you come from phi of s to f of t, you do ILT. So that is inverse Laplace transform. So I can say L inverse of phi of s, that is equal to 1 upon 2 pi minus infinity to infinity e raised to st phi of s with respect to ds, that will be equal to f of t. Now this definition of inverse Laplace transform, we use it for finding standard inverse Laplace transform formulas. But as we know, Laplace transform formulas are given by Laplace of sin a t is a upon s square plus a square. So we can say L inverse of 1 divided by s square plus a square is equal to 1 upon a sin a t. In the similar way, we can write Laplace inverse formulas of all functions. So Laplace of cos a t is s upon s square plus a square. So L inverse of s upon s square plus a square, that is equal to cos a t. Next is Laplace of e raised to, I say plus minus at, is equal to 1 upon s minus plus a, that is exactly opposite sign. So in inverse, we can say 1 upon s minus plus a, that is equal to e raised to plus minus at. So next will be, I'll be writing directly Laplace inverse of 1 upon s square minus a square, that is equal to 1 by a sine hyperbolic a t. In the same way, L inverse of s upon s square minus a square, that is equal to cos hyperbolic a t. Now, next will be, if we find L inverse of k by s, so I get constant. So where we know k is nothing but a constant term. Now next is the most important. When we write Laplace inverse of 1 upon s raised to n, that is equal to t raised to n minus 1 divided by n minus 1 factorial. So students, we know we will be using factorial when n will be integer. If n is a rational number, I'll be using t raised to n minus 1 divided by gamma of n. So we have seen Laplace inverse formulas. So they were standard formulas. Thank you for watching in 5 minutes.